Welcome back, guys. Welcome back to the part 5 of MidJourney tutorial series. In this part, I'm going to cover the multi-prompt and how you can control the multi-prompt with values. All right, let's get started. All right, let's see a simple example first, and then we can go into an advanced example. I'm just going to type, imagine snowman. Okay. Now, you guys can see it has created a snowman. That's what we asked for. But what if this is not what we asked for? We asked for a man in snow. Okay, so in that case, we can use the multi-prompt. Now, I'm going to type again, imagine, and then snow. After the snow, I'm going to enter 2 double colon again, and space. Now, I'm going to type man. Okay, let's enter. Now, you guys can see it has created a man and snow. All right, guys, so this is how you can use the multi-prompt to separate the words. Okay, pretty simple, right? And then we also can have a wait for each of these words as well. Okay, so in here we have the man and the snow, but you barely see the snow. What if I want the snow to be more prominent, man to be less prominent? I can do that also. All I need to do is I can go in here and imagine I'm going to type again, snow, double colon. Then after the colon, I can enter a weight. Okay, by default, the weight is 1. Even though there is no number, each of these has the number 1 as the weight. All right, so I'm just going to say 2 and space, and then I'm going to say man. All right, and enter. Now, if you see compared to this image in here, we have more snow. Wait for it to load. I don't know, recently it's getting very slow. Anyway, you guys can see the results in here. Let's make it even more prominent, all right? I'm going to copy this prompt again, snow and man. And this time, instead of 2, I'm going to make it like 5, all right? And I'm going to cut this one. First, I need to enter the imagine prompt, and then enter. Okay, let's see. Okay, now you guys can see these two in here, we have a clear difference. Okay, but if we enter 5, let's see how it will look. So when you increase the number, you must be careful also, guys, because sometimes it won't work as human things. So maybe when I increase the number to 5, it may change the eyes, but also it will affect the man as well. It can even change the man to woman. So this is what I exactly say. You see, now it increased the height, but it didn't change a lot, but it affected the man, the word man, and it changed to the woman. So we must stick to the smaller number, okay? For version 4, we can enter decibel numbers as well. For MidJourney version 4. For the older versions, you can only enter full numbers, okay? And I will give you guys another example in here. So in here, instead of snowman 5, 2.5 or something like that, then we will have more snow. But when we enter 5, it's changing the entire thing, even the man, okay? And also one more thing you guys need to remember, by default, it's snow 1. And in here, if we separate the word, it should be something like that. Snow 1, man 1, snow and man, which is just this one in here, are same. Okay. And if I put snow 2 and man 1, or snow 100 and man 50, these two are exactly the same. Okay. It's the difference between these two numbers, not the number alone. All right, guys? So this part you guys need to know. And to have a little bit more variation, don't go into a bigger number. Just stick to smaller numbers. But let's keep this like this just to see how it will look. As you guys can see here, there is not much difference. It made the woman even younger and the snow didn't change a lot. Okay. All right, guys. So this is the basics of multi-prompt. Let's look into advanced multi-prompt. Okay. I'm going to type in here abundant city. Okay. For the first phrase, abundant city. And for the number, I'm just going to give 1.2. Remember, guys, for the version 4, we can have decimal points. Okay, so the importance of the city part, I want to give 1.2. And then covered by grass. Okay, and for this, I'm going to give 2. All right, this one, I don't need a space. And then the third part of this sentence is going to be backlight. I want the light to be from behind, all right? And for this, I'm going to say 2 as well, okay? All right, now we can give a parameter also for this. I'm going to say the AR 2 by 1, aspect ratio 2 by 1. All right, I think this is good enough. Let's enter and see how our image will be created. Alright, it has created something for us. If I click in here, you can see I actually wanted something like this in here. Alright, and this also looks nice, but my original idea was to be having something like this in here. So we can stick to this image and use the remix mode to add in more things into this image. Okay, so with the multi-prompt, we can use the remix mode as well. And then by adding in more prompt into the remix prompt, we can get closer to what we wanted. All right. Okay. Oops, I accidentally clicked on the wrong icon. I should have clicked on the V1 icon to create the remix variation, but it's all right. All right, actually, this time it has created even more nicer image, I feel like. I like both of these. Let's say we like this image. I want to change the color and look and feel of this image, all right? So I'm going to select V1 and I'm going to select the remix the image, okay? And in here, I want more buildings. So I'm going to say 1.5. Covered by grass, let's stick to 2. Backlight also, I'm just going to stick to 2. And after the backlight, I'm going to enter one more thing. Okay, in here, I'm going to say it shot with a DSLR camera. So I'm just going to say DSLR. And then we can enter a value for this one also. 1.2 again. And after this, let's add in a color. For this, I'm going to add in foil. Okay, so I want something very
shiny, like a foil, and also the overall look and feel, I want it to be like a muddy, you know, the old film look. Okay,
for this also, I'm going to enter a value of 2. Okay, and space. Actually, so when we enter 2, 2, 2 in here, this all going to look the same. It's all in equal values, not look the same, it all in the equal values. I need to increase the grass, so let's put it like 3, all right? And let's sum it and see how it will look. All right, guys, you can see we have more grass in here, but I don't like the lighting. Let's say I want to change the lighting in here again. I will stick to image 1 in here. Maybe we go back in here and click on version 1. Let's stick to this image. So this time, I'm going to change this backlight to something else completely. Let's change it to crepuscular rays.
It's just a fancy word to add in more rays. You know, when the sunset scene or sunrise scene, we have the rays. That's what it means. So it will create some rays in the scene. Okay. And then
I'm going to change the abundant city to 2 and the grass, let's make it 1. Okay, so you can just take out this part completely, which will create 1, but you need to keep the double colon. Okay, so this means actually the covered by grass, there is a value 1. You don't need to enter the value 1. As I said, by default, number 1 is added. All right, okay, so let's submit and see how it will look. So now you guys can see we get what we wanted. We want the rays. We got the rays and we have increased the building size and decreased the grass in here. And also we have changed the color. So this is how you guys can use the multiprompt and use the values to control the multiprompt.
Pretty simple, right? All right, guys. So that's all about it for today.
In the next part, let's see how to use the seed and using multiprompt and seed together, how to create the same design again and again with different inputs. All right, guys, thank you for watching. See you guys in the next tutorial.